Hi, this is Justin Sims from Louisiana Assistive Technology Initiative, and I am introducing to you Javora, a hilarious and extraordinary student born with anthetoid cerebral palsy, which affects his ability to vocalize speech, keep his body in an upright position, and control the movement of his arms, legs, and head. He wouldn't fully be this whimsical and eccentric young man as you're about to see if it wasn't for a team collaboration between PT, OT, speech therapy, teachers, paraprofessionals, Lottie itself, and everyone else involved in his life. Javora now uses a PRC Accent 1400 with a joystick to navigate the cursor, a button by his knee to click his choice, and a toggle switch to alternate the joystick between controlling the communication device and steering his wheelchair. The first part of this video will be a very unscripted conversation with Javora, followed by an interview with his speech pathologist about what it took to get Javora where he is today.
Javora is the smartest person in the world.
You're the smartest person in the world, Javora? Well, you're going to be on YouTube. Is there any shout-outs? Anyone you want to talk to on the internet?
Beyonce.
Beyonce? What do you want to tell Beyonce?
I wish.
Well, we'll have to see what we can do about that.
Yeah.
You get all her money.
I can't help you with that one.
I can't either.
I get all her money.
Javora, do you like school?
No.
Why don't you like school, Javora?
Maybe.
Maybe?
Yes.
What do you like about school?
Study.
Yeah, I bet you have to study a lot, huh? What do you like to do when you're not at school? What do you like to do at home?
Plays. Nice. Mr. Potato Head.
You like to play Mr. Potato Head?
Study playing Mr. Potato Head.
Who plays with you?
Mom. Want to hear a joke?
Yes, I do. I would love to hear a joke.
Why did the cookie go to the doctor?
Why did... Oh my goodness.
How is the baby?
Oh, thanks for asking.
How is the baby?
Do you want to see a picture?
Yes.
Yay!
That was the better.
He rolled over for the first time last night.
He should. B. Name. Javora. You should be named Javora.
Oh, I know. You told me before that he was a boy, and I didn't believe you. And you were right. He was a boy, and I should name him Javora. But you know what? Would you settle for if we just nickname him Javora?
Yes.
All right. We'll just call him Javora. Look how big. He kind of looks like you.
I am on the football team, quarterback.
You play the quarterback? What? Starting quarterback?
Yes.
Go! You must have all the ladies.
At least just the ones with money.
Yes.
How many of them? How many ladies?
Two. Eight. Zero. 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 I have 28,000.
28,000? 28,000 what?
Girlfriend. Two AOO girlfriends. I have two AOO girlfriends.
28,000 girlfriends. Now I know you are clowning, boy. You can't afford that many Valentine's Day gifts.
Yes.
No way. No way. That's awesome, too. What else do you like about high school?
Whoa.
Besides all the girls and playing quarterback for the football team.
Is there any studying you like to do? Any good studying?
No.
Of course not.
You know, some people think that you can't use devices like that, that you can't use the joystick to talk. Mm. What would you tell them if they told you you couldn't use this to talk?
You are wrong.
I would agree with you. How long have you been working with Javora? I know you don't work with him right now.
Right.
How long did you work with Javora?
3 years. I worked with him since August of 2014 when school started.
Did he have the device then?
No, he didn't. When I met him, it was the beginning of school. And he was working with a para. He had a dry erase board, and they would ask him a question, and they would have three different answers on the dry erase board. And he would reach over and hit the right answer.
How consistent was that? Because I know he has trouble.
Fairly consistent. You knew with gestures and vocalizations, if he was in between two, you can, you know.
How did you start from there? How did you get from dry erase board to a dedicated device?
So from there, I told the teacher, I said, it looks like he's in there, he just needs to speak. And she said, yes. And she had been working with him since 2010. And they had tried a scanning, but his motor skills were so inconsistent that he would miss his targeted icon, so it really wasn't very appropriate. And also, it was extremely limited. He can only request a few things because it was just one page. So my training in grad school was with Dr. Banaji, and originally I contacted her because I didn't know about the AT Center right away, and I asked her if I could use some devices. then I found out about the AAC Center and their devices, so I borrowed from them and we started trying from there. Originally, we thought eye gaze might be a good way, but his visual skill, we really never could get a good reading using multiple different brands. Mm-hmm. And his also head positioning was an issue. So when he'd get tired, his head would droop and then
that would be a whole new calibration.
Right, exactly. So that's when we started to take a whole team approach to it. And we had the OT, PT, wheelchair representative, his teacher, and I all came together. And it was really the physical therapist who thought about, well, since he's so good with the joystick, is there a way we can use the joystick to communicate?
How quickly did he take to using the joystick?
He did it fairly quickly, but he required a lot of extended time to make his responses. Mm-hmm. Even now, he still needs extended time, but he is much quicker than he was before.
What was everyone's reaction when he started straight up using the joystick with an accent?
Tears. Lots of happy tears. It was really neat. I think one of the first things he said was, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Pretty cool.
So did you, I guess you had glimpses, but did you know he had so much personality before he had the dedicated device with a joystick?
I mean, you could tell he was a happy, go lucky, joking kid, but I never knew that much was in there. I had no idea.
You never knew he wouldn't be on Save for the Money.
No. No, or that he was going to be the next president so that he can have the first lady.
How much training happened in the classroom to get this started and at home?
A lot of training in the classroom. We had several formal meetings where we would explain the device, but then almost every day, just trying to figure out what to teach him first, how to teach him, and where to go to get the biggest bang for our buck.
Yeah, what did you start with?
We started. Let's see.
It sounds like his receptive language was pretty high by this point, right? How old was he when he started using accent?
He was 10.
He was 10 years old?
Mm-hmm. So 9 or 10.
10 years of hearing people talk to him. So did he quickly pick up on this says this and it has a meaning, I would imagine?
Right. Well, yeah. An interesting fact is 1 year after he started using the accent, his receptive standard score increased by 15 points.
15 points.
Isn't that incredible?
That's big, yeah.
And a huge jump. We started with some basic requests like core words, go, more, stop, finish, with a few interjections. Good, I like that. Once he knew enough vocabulary, and of course we were teaching him how to, we started with requesting, but then when he started to combine, we were modeling, increasing utterance length. When he started to combine them, then that's where we kind of divided and conquered. Like his teacher was teaching him how to ask questions, use the vocabulary to ask questions. The parents in his classroom were teaching him vocabulary on the device. And then I would walk around the school and teach him how to use it with people in a functional way. And that's how we found that it worked very well.
Yeah. Would you put him in social situations?
Oh, absolutely.
Can you tell us about one?
Okay, yeah. So we went outside for recess, and he just sat in the back in the corner, and that's how it started. Like, first we had to teach him how to approach peers, and then what to do once he got there. So once he got there, he would, even with his device in front of him, he would just sit there, and they would ask a question, he would just look at them with a blank face. You had to say, remember, you have your talker now, use it.
You have an opportunity.
Right, and slowly but surely he would, and it took a lot of role-playing in the therapy room first, and now he's a hoot. He's funny. He jokes with everybody.
I can tell.
But he would talk about, he'd like to, with one peer, he went up to him and he asked, how are you? What'd you do over the weekend? And then he proceeded to say how he went to a party and stayed up till 2 a.m.
And you thought he was lying.
And yeah, I did. I thought he was
telling
lying.
Telling stories.
I'm bringing him back to his room, and another student who turned out to be his cousin says, hey, Javora, how you doing? I saw you last night, and I was like, what? And Javora says, yeah, at the party. I said, what? Y'all were at a party? He said, yeah, we were at a party till 2 a.m. on a Sunday night. So he was telling the truth. That's his cousin. His cousin was at the party with him.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
That's good.
I thought he was just joking.
No, he was for real.
He was.
Has this experience with Javora and the success he had changed your view or your approaches to some students with disabilities, knowing what you know now?
I think it...
Or you came out right out of the gate just knowing, I'm going to change the world and make a difference. Because you just got out of graduate school.
Yeah.
And you got a big win. I mean, you just changed your life so fast.
It makes you feel like this is my once in a lifetime or my one and only, and it just happened really quick.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I think it helped me because I, like, perseverance-wise, I don't know, just that anything was possible, because we did hit so many roadblocks with him on every level. You know, when Javora got frustrated because we didn't have the selection switch in the right access spot, and he shut down, or when the teacher said it was just too difficult to, like, they didn't know how to teach him, or when administration said that, you know, I couldn't bill insurance, or, you know, we had every different hurdle, and we all worked through them and came together as a team to benefit the student. So it's pretty cool. So I guess now, no matter what level the child is, I always give them a chance with a device, and I maybe wouldn't have done that before Javora.
Yeah. Is that what you would recommend to other people in similar situations?
Absolutely. Even a student who you know, has tantrums and throws things on the ground and bites, as you know, they still can use an expensive iPad or device appropriately without destroying it.
Yeah, at least having modeled right.
Right, exactly.
Thank you so much for watching our video. We really want to bring some more content, so make sure to like and subscribe. That really helps us out. And thanks again.